Hi everyone, Kevin here. Today, we're going to look at how you can make a beautiful looking resume in Microsoft Word that will help you land your dream job. We'll also look at how you can leverage the power of AI to make your resume stand out to hiring managers. Let's check out how to do this. To make a resume in Microsoft Word, head to the following website. You can also click on a link down below in the description. This is where you'll find all of the different Microsoft 365 templates. Up above, you can search for a template, but even better, if you look down just a little bit, right here we have trending searches, and there's an option for resumes. That's exactly what we're looking for, so let's click on that. This opens up a page with all sorts of different resumes that you can create in Microsoft Word, and you have all sorts of different options. Some of them have photos, others don't. If we go up to the very top, over on the right-hand side of the search field, you'll also see the option to filter down all of the different resumes. For example, we can filter by color. Maybe you want a hint of red on your resume. When I click on that, here we see a few different options that include red. Maybe you just want a very classy and traditional resume. Right here, we could filter based on white, and here we have a few different options. We could also look at black, and again, many different ways to filter the different resumes. I'll click on this, and let's clear all these different filters. Now, right over here, this resume looks interesting. Let me click on this one, and here I can see an enlarged version of the resume. Over on the left-hand side, I can customize in Word, and this uses Word on the web. The great thing is you can use this entirely for free. You don't even have to subscribe to Microsoft 365 to be able to make a resume in Word. However, if you have the desktop app, I'd recommend clicking on download, and then you could do it directly in the desktop app. Here I am now on the homepage of the Microsoft Word desktop app, and we can also get to all of those different resume templates directly from here. Over on the left-hand side, let's click on a new document. And if we look down just a little bit, here too we also have a template search field. Down below, we can filter based on different template types, and here's an option for resumes and cover letters. And when I click on that, here too, you'll see all the different template options. Now, the one downside of finding a template directly in the desktop app, you don't have those same filter functions, for example, based on the color. But here too, we see the same set of templates. Right here, I see that same exact resume that we saw earlier on the web. I'd like to use this one to make a resume, so I'll click on this. Here we see that enlarged version, and then I'll click on Create. This now opens up the resume template in Microsoft Word, and I can now start customizing it to match all of my information. In the top left-hand corner, the first thing that I should probably change is the photo. This is not me. That would be really awkward to go into an interview with a different person on my resume. To change out the picture, simply click on it and you'll see that it's selected. Then right-click and at the very top, you'll see this option for fill. Click on that and if we go down this menu, there's the option for picture. Let's click on that. You have all these different options. I happen to have a photo of me on my computer, so I'll click on from a file. And there's the photo of me right there. I'll select this and then click on insert. This has now inserted my photo, but you'll notice that the dimensions or the aspect ratio is slightly off. With the photo still selected, up on top on the top tabs, let's go over to the option that says picture format. When you click on that, all the way over on the right-hand side, let's click on crop, and at the very bottom of this menu, you have two different options, fill and fit. Let's select the one that says fill. Currently, it's set to fit. When I click on that, that now changes the photo. That looks a lot better. And here I can adjust the photo to get it to fill this place perfectly. I think that spot looks good. So I'll click out and that's great. Now that I've added a photo, let's shift our focus down to the profile section. And this is where you get to showcase why you're a great fit for the job. Of course, you could come through here and attempt to write something on your own, and I would recommend doing that. But let's also take a look at how AI can assist you with crafting a beautifully written profile section. Here I am on the Microsoft Bing Chat website, and this allows you to use GPT-4 entirely for free. Down below, you can choose a conversation style, and I find that when writing text for a resume, creative tends to work very well, so I'll select that style. Now, down below, you can ask the AI anything. So here, I'll type in a prompt. Can you help me write a summary for my resume? Here's what I do. And then I entered in some high-level bullet points of what I accomplished here at the Kevin Cookie Company. So feel free to do the same thing. Once you enter in all of your different text, in the bottom right-hand corner, let's see what the AI comes back with. And just like magic, it's now written out some sentences that incorporate all of my different accomplishments. A successful entrepreneur and leader with 10 years of experience in the cookie industry, founded and grew a cookie business, and on and on. That sounds really good to me. Now here, I can simply highlight all this text and copy it and now bring it back to my resume. I'm now back in Word with my resume, and right down here I have that profile section. I'll simply click on that and that highlights all of the text. Then I'll press Control V to paste all of the text from the AI, and that looks pretty good. But you'll notice that the formatting doesn't match the formatting of the rest of the document. I'll click on this icon, and over here I just want to keep the text. This way it'll adopt the formatting that was already in place, and this now looks pretty good. One word of caution with AI. Sometimes AI hallucinates or basically makes up information. Whenever you use any type of content from AI, go back and verify to make sure that everything is accurate. With your resume, you want to put your best foot forward, so totally fine to use AI, but you also don't want to invent things. Unless, of course, you're an inventor, in which case talk about all the different things that you've invented. Now that we have a profile, down below you could fill in your contact information. And make sure to enter this correctly. The last thing you want is for someone one number off to get your interview. Down below, you could also type in your hobbies. Baking cookies is totally fair. Right up above, you could also type in your name, your job title, and also any of your education. Now, right down below, we also have the work experience, and this is by far one of the most important sections of your resume. This is where you talk about what type of roles you've had and what you accomplished in those roles. Right here, it asks for the company name, so I'll put down the Kevin Cookie Company, and also my job title while I worked there. I was a senior distinguished executive baker. I know the title's kind of crazy, but that's what it was. Right here, you could also enter in the dates. Now, down below, this is where you can describe your responsibilities and also your achievements. I would recommend only entering in about 3 to 4 bullet points. Think of this as a movie trailer or your highlights. Also, you want to make sure that you put the most important ones first and the less important ones later. Why is that? Well, hiring managers start from top to bottom, and they may not make it to the bottom. Let's now try writing one of these bullet points together. That way, you get a feel of a very good structure. I'll click on this, and this highlights all of this text. Right up here, I'll insert a bullet, and then I'll delete this text. I always recommend starting out with a very strong action verb. So think of verbs like built, designed, led, drove. And I would avoid weaker verbs like participated, helped, assisted. On your resume, you want to show what you did or what you accomplished, and those strong action verbs will help. For this bullet point, I'll start by entering in built the Kevin Cookie Company. That's a really nice strong action verb. You might be wondering, why didn't I say I built the Kevin Cookie Company? I didn't use a personal pronoun. Well, this entire resume is all about me, so it's implied that this was me who took this action. So here I have my action, built the Kevin Cookie Company. Now, I also recommend including some context. So I'll enter in from scratch into a global leader in the baked goods industry. And lastly, you also want to quantify or show the impact of what you did. So think of numbers or percentages here. So lastly, I'll say generating over $5 billion per year from 1,000 retail locations. So right at the beginning, I have the action, we have a little bit of context, and then right at the very end, here we have the impact. That's always a very good structure for bullet points in your resume. Now that I have this, let's do the same thing that we did with the profile section. Let's see if AI can maybe look at this bullet point and offer some recommendations on how to make it even stronger. I'll copy all of this text and let's head back over to Bing Chat. Back now within Bing Chat, down at the very bottom, I'll ask, how can I improve this bullet point for a resume? And here's the bullet point that we both just wrote together. Right over here, let's see what it comes back with. Right up above, I can now see all the different feedback. For example, it recommends using a different strong action verb to start my bullet point. For example, instead of built, maybe I say founded or established or launched. Those probably sound better, so I'd probably go with one of those. Here, there are some other recommendations. Down at the very bottom, it also rewrites my bullet points and it gives me a few different options. Now, I think some of these are probably better than what I had and I could leverage these. Again, it's not making up new information. Instead, it's taking what I already had and it's making it better. AI can really help your resume stand out so you could land that job. Once you're all done working on your resume, you probably want to share it out. And the PDF file format tends to work really well for that. To save your document as a PDF, in the top left-hand corner, click on the File menu. Then go down to the option that says export. And right here, you can create a PDF. Then just click on this button and you'll now have your new resume in PDF format. All right, well, hopefully you now have a beautiful looking resume. To watch more videos like this one, please consider subscribing, and I hope to see you in the next video.